When you think of great cathedrals around the world, I wonder what comes to mind. Great cathedrals throughout Europe and, of course, Latin America, all over the world. The latter part of our Australian history is short, but notable cathedrals have been built, and St. Andrew's in Sydney is a very significant one. And Kanishka Raffel, it's a delight to have you on the show today.
Thanks very much, Keith.
Your role is the Dean of St. Andrew's. Tell me what the Dean does.
Well, the Dean is, if you like, the senior minister in the cathedral. So my privilege really is to oversee our ministry.
And you're very much recognising the diocese and the work that you do. You're very much a mission church, aren't you?
Yeah, absolutely. I like to say that the doors of the cathedral are open, physically and metaphorically. Mm-hmm. We want to be serving the city by proclaiming the Lord Jesus Christ and sharing God's love with everybody we can in every possible way that we can.
How long have you been there?
I've been there since 2016, so just over 3 years.
So tell us a bit about your story, because how you became a minister, how the Christian faith came alive for you.
Well, my family background is Sri Lankan. We came to Australia in 1972, I was raised a Buddhist. My mother's family were Buddhist. My father's family actually were Dutch Reform Christians in Sri Lanka, but as children we were raised as Buddhists. So that was how I identified, and that's what I understood myself to be right up until my university days. And in fact, during university, I thought I ought to get serious about my religion. Mm-hmm. And so I did quite a lot of reading in Buddhism and was actively practicing, I suppose you would say. Mm-hmm. And then at the end of my third year, I had a conversation with a Christian friend of mine. I think I'd been... I had new confidence in my Buddhism, so I engaged my Christian friends.
You were out to change him, you were.
Something like that. And in response to my question, you know, what does being a Christian mean to you? He said, being a Christian means I've lost control of my life to Jesus Christ.
Which is the exact opposite of what a Buddhist really believes.
Absolutely, you're exactly right. I was thinking, well... here am I trying by every kind of personal discipline to take control of my life, not just the sort of day-to-day physical circumstances of it, but my
spirituality,
internal life and my mental life and so on. So it was quite an extraordinary thing for him to say, and it really struck me. Mm-hmm. He offered me something to read, that's what he said. I thought we discussed C.S. Lewis from time to time, so I thought he might give me some C.S. Lewis, but he didn't. He gave me Mark's Gospel and John's Gospel.
Great. These are the two that I would choose, really. Mark the shortest, the fastest, and
yes,
John the much
right.
more spiritual.
Yeah. And so it was some weeks later, I started to read John. I felt that I'd made an undertaking to do it and that I needed to do it, and it was a kind of humid Sydney night, actually, and I was just home alone in my bedroom, and I thought, perhaps I can put myself to sleep by reading John's Gospel. But in fact, of course, it woke me up to the life and love of God. So I'm tremendously grateful.
Now, fast forward into the work you do now. You obviously feel the call, you're ordained, you're trained. But the mission you've got now, did that kind of conversion story, does that equip you in some ways for the role you're doing now?
Well... we've been away from Sydney for 20 years, so my wife and I, with our family, we served first of all in Canberra and then in Perth. So coming back to Sydney after 20 years, it's a city that has, and right into the heart of the city where the cathedral is on George Street, very conscious of how cosmopolitan, multicultural, of course, the towering spires of commerce and retail and what have you. And you might think, well, now how are you going to proclaim the gospel in this context? So I guess in terms of my own journey and the kind of contribution that makes, one is, of course, that Jesus is for everyone. Mm-hmm. It doesn't belong to one culture. Mm-hmm. And so a multicultural city like Sydney is just as good a place to proclaim the gospel as anywhere else, because he's the Lord of all and the Lord of every nation. And so, and in fact, that's exactly what we find, actually. We have people from all kinds of countries joining us for services or just walking into the cathedral to have a look around. Mm-hmm. And very often people who don't know very much about Christianity and are quite happy to learn about it. We've got, you know, gospel tracts in 17 different languages. And one of our volunteers just keeps a track of how many are going out the door of each language. And it's wonderful to think
of. As we draw to a close, we're neighbours in a way, Wesley Mission and the Cathedral, and we're both in the city. How does your building help you? Do you think it does?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, it is a feature of the city. This year we're celebrating 200 years since the laying of the foundation stone, 150 years the doors have been open. And so it is a landmark, it is quite beautiful, if I say so myself. Mm. And so I think people do wonder, what is this building? What happens here? Mm. Why was it built? Mm. What is its purpose today? There is a curiosity, but there's also an openness. People are happy to come into it.
Well, we're delighted to see you, and I hope perhaps by people meeting you in their own homes, they might come meet you at your home
too. We'd love that.
And thank you ever so much for sharing with us.